Good morning students, how are you? I think you are fine. Once again, welcome to online classes. I'm very happy to meet you once again through this online classes. Okay, in your previous class we discussed about the two important chapters. Do you remember it? Yes, atmosphere and industries in our country. That means we learn the two important lessons in the previous classes, atmosphere and industries. Of course, now we are going to learn about another important chapter, that is called as agriculture in our country, in our India. Agriculture in our India, we have to learn about these things. My dear children, do you like play? Yes, the everybody must like play. That means how can you play? Listen, if you became a strengthy, if you became a healthy, automatically you can play well in the playground. You get you may win this games. How do you get the strength? Yes, because of a sufficient food. When you take a sufficient food, your body become a strengthened, then you actively play games in the playground along with your friends. Listen, yes, in every country agriculture plays an important role. Why? Without agriculture there is no country, there is no people also. Why? Because I am telling, nowadays the technology was well developed. The developed nations are making or producing the different kinds of dreadful weapons as in today. Yes, of course, sometimes that is must to protect the territories of its every nation. The first thing is the every human being must eat food. The every human being must eat food only. Understand? How do you get the food? Yes, through agriculture. Yes, now we are going to discover about our Indian agriculture. Yes, that means from the beginning, our India is predominantly an agriculture nation. Our India is a predominantly an agriculture nation. Okay. Aged world, our agriculture is an economic activity. Because of that, some economists told agriculture is the backbone of our Indian economy. Agriculture is the backbone of our Indian economy. Okay, understand? Agriculture is the backbone of Indian economy. In your previous class, we learnt about industries. Different types of industries we learn. Among them, agro-based industries also most important for that, I told. That means if there is no agricultural development, there is industries. Example, I told agro-based industries. That is called as cotton, jute, sugarcane. These industries are mostly depend upon agriculture only. If agriculture was well developed, automatically the relevant industries are also well developed. So in every country, not only our country, in the world, yes, agriculture is played a most important role in every country. Of course, about our India, as since the ages, the people of India depend upon agriculture only. Listen, depend upon agriculture only. Listen, nowadays, of course, that is 1972 and 73, nearly 74% of people are depend upon agriculture. Understand? 1972 and 73 ages, decades, the 74% of the people are depend upon agriculture only. Of course, now it is reduced to only 53% because most of the persons got educated people, they are looking for very good employment jobs. So, actually, yes, in our India, nowadays, industrial sector was developed, service sector is also well developed. Whatever the sectors developed in our country, still today, as and today, the agriculture provides a number of employment opportunities. Due to industries, the production was increased only. A sufficient employment opportunity is not available in industrial sector and the service sector. But still today, the many people in our country and depend upon agriculture only. That is the most important point. Understand or not? Whatever the industries are developed or service sector may develop, definitely still today the many people in our country depend upon agriculture only. Because of that, agriculture is the backbone of our Indian economy, I told. Listen. Nowadays, the agriculture was somewhat changed. It is technological change and the socio-economic changes are there. Yes, what is technology? In the beginning, 1970s and 73, 75, the farmers used only the primitive tools in agriculture. That is called a traditional methods, but in modern time, nowadays, in the place of traditional methods, they utilizing technological methods and scientific methods are there. As because using these kind of techniques and scientific methods, nowadays, the Indian agriculture yielding very good yieldings in our Indian agriculture. Okay, understand or not? Okay, listen. Yes, even developed nations, the scientist cannot eat any atom bombs, the scientist cannot eat any missiles, either in our Indian scientists or foreign scientists. They only human beings, they can eat food only. Because of that, the every country given a priority to agriculture. Do you know, already I told in your previous class, after independence, India given a top priority to agriculture, the first five year plan, because the population is increasing day by day. So they construct dams across the river and provide irrigation facilities, the more agriculture land brought under cultivation. Because of that, food grains are sufficient for us as and today. Listen, I can tell. Listen. Yes, in our India, the agriculture may two types. That is called as the substantial, simple substantial form and intensive substantial form. Simple subsistence agriculture. I can write simple subsistence farming. forming. Second one, intensive substance forming. Yes, what is called simple substance forming, and what is intense substance forming, we can learn. Actually, yes, in our country, the agriculture may divide into three important categories. That is extensive agriculture, intensive agriculture, and podu agriculture. Once again, in our country, our agriculture may be divided into three categories. One is extensive agriculture. Second, intensive agriculture. Third one, podu agriculture. Yes, simply I can explain what is extensive agriculture. The extensive agriculture is mostly belongs to developed nations. What is extensive? Extensive agriculture means the same piece of land, the same time, they cultivate different crops. Once again, the same piece of land, the farmers cultivate different kinds of crops. Suppose if I divide it into, like these guys, here paddy, here sugar cane, here another crop, here vegetables, here orchards, like that. It has here the farmhouse are there. This is called as extensive agriculture. But our India is not extensive agriculture. America, Britain, they are countries, are Australia, these developed nations now follows extensive agriculture, because in the same piece of land, in the same year, they cultivate different kinds of crops in a year. That is called as extensive. But what about India? In India, we are following intensive agriculture. What is intensive agriculture means, in the same piece of land, or 1 hectare of land, or other things, in the same piece of land, the farmer get more than two crops. It is different. The same time, the farmer may yield different kinds of crops in extensive agriculture. It is purely, they may provide all these facilities, transport facilities and electricity facilities and the water facilities. That is called as a farmhouse. But India is not like that. India is intensive agriculture. That means the same piece of land, yearly more than two crops they are getting. That is Kharif and Rabi, and next one, Jayad. These three crops, that is yes, that in the intensive agriculture they use technological methods, and intensive labor farming. It is called as intensive labor farming. That means it may provide employment in agriculture sector, so it is called as intensive agriculture. Third one, podu agriculture. What is called podu agriculture? In which places in India, which people in India have to do this kind of podu agriculture? Yes, podu agriculture is also called shifting agriculture. What is called podu agriculture? Mainly the tribal people who are living in forest areas, they only cultivate to podu agriculture. That means cut the forest and cultivate the land. Understand or not? What is called the podu agriculture? Podu agriculture means the tribal people mostly do this type of agriculture only. That means they cut the forest, they cultivate the land. Suppose this is forest, you feel this is a forest. This is forest. That means what happened the first time that these tribal people up to here cut the forest. Yes, up to here cut the forest, this land may cultivate. Of course, this land give very good yieldings for some years. After some years, a continuous cultivation of the land, they lost its fertility. They lost its fertility. Then automatically yieldings may decrease. Then the agriculture is not profitable. When the agriculture land is not profitable to the farmer, automatically he left it and again cut this area of the forest. Again, this is also cut. The now the farmer may shift from here to here. And again, it is also cut like this. So the farmers simply shift from this place to this place. That means cut the forest and cultivate the land. So this less fertile land may use for the construction of houses and other purpose they use. So understand what is called extensive agriculture, what is called intensive agriculture, and what is called podu agriculture. The podu agriculture is also called as shifting cultivation and also called zooming cultivation. That means the people may shift from this area to this area when it was the last fertility, from here to here. So they may shift from one place to another place continuously. They are cut the forest is called as podu agriculture. Understand? Extensive, intensive, and podu are called zooming cultivation and also called as a shifting cultivation. Okay, so that is I am clearly explaining about the what type of agricultures are grown in our India. India is mostly followed. Only intensive agriculture. Yes, first of all, in the simple subsistence farming, people may use the traditional methods and the primitive tools like hoe, digging sticks, and diavo, sickle, etc. use in farming. That means the manpower and animal power use in shifting, in a simple subsistence type of farming. That means man use bullocks to plow the land. The man use bullock carts to carry the load, transport the goods from one place to another place. And also, only the family members may cultivate this type of simple substantial farming. Understand or not? That means the primitive tools may use in the simple farming. And also, these type of agriculture mostly depend upon rainfall, the natural resources like monsoons, like water depend upon this kind of. So this type of agriculture in our country is called as simple substantial farming. Yes, the podu agriculture is called as slash and burn. It is called as a slash and burn. Second one, intensive intensive substance farming. Yes, what is called intensive substance farming means yes in this type of cultivation the farmer may use high dosage of chemicals for getting high yieldings. In this farming the farmer use may some scientific methods. Do you know, once upon a time 70s and 80s they are using manpower in agriculture sector, but nowadays they are using machine power. The man may use sickle for harvesting, but nowadays in the place of manpower for transporting, plowing the land and for water facilities and threshing and everything, they utilizing machine power, and also more biochemicals are utilizing to fertile the soil and getting high yields. So this is called as intensive substance farming. Now we are going to discuss about the commercial type of farming. Yes, what is called commercial type of farming? I can explain you. Listen. Yes, in this type of agriculture, the farmer may use high doses of biochemicals to get high yielding. I told. Yes, it is absolutely right, because nowadays the farmers use in the place of manpower, they using the machine power, and also in the primitive type of it, in the place of primitive type of agriculture, they use scientific methods. They are utilizing the scientific methods in our country. So this is yes, the farmer use input scientific methods. Listen, actually in agriculture sector or any other sector, input and output is there. Do you know what is called input, what is called output? Understand? Input and output. If you give the input, then we get output only. Without input, no, you can't expect any output. Of course, in your sixth and seventh, in your primary classes, your computer teachers teach you about output and input. Output and input. What is input and what is output? Yes, if you want to give the bags of paddy, 10 bags of paddy or 20 bags of paddy, whatever it may be, that is output. Before going to expect output, you must give input, that is seeds. Seeds, input. Yes, generally the government's using input subsidies. The word they are using, input subsidy. Yes, that nothing but input means seeds, labor, fertilizers. Pesticides and so these are important. Understand? Once again, what are called input? Seeds, labor, fertilizers, fertilizers. Yes, when use these kind of inputs in the agriculture sector, then only we have got output. That means output means after giving this input, in the yield. For 1 acre, the farmer may get 15 bags or 30 bags or 25 bags or 50 bags, that is means input and output. Do you understand what is the difference between input and output? Input means we must give. Suppose if your teacher give you input, then only you will get output of good marks in your education. Understand or not? So yes, that is the difference between input and output. Listen, I told you about the commercialization of the crops. What is the commercialization of the crops? That means, listen, you take paddy. In one state, the one kind of food grain is cash crop in other state. Example, paddy you take. Yes, paddy. In our South Indian states like Andhra Pradesh, Odisha, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, etc., this paddy is a main food crop in our South Indian states, particularly Andhra Pradesh and Odisha and Tamil Nadu and Karnataka. These people use paddy as a food, main food crop. Understand? The same paddy is cash crop in Punjab and Haryana, some other North Indian states. Understand? Example, wheat. Wheat is the main food crop of Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh and some other North Indian states. That means what you understand? Because paddy is main food crop of South Indian people like Andhra Pradesh and Orissa, etc. The same paddy is a cash crop in North Indian states, like Punjab and Haryana. That means they take very little food only. In our state also, yes, oftenly we take chapatis. Of course, we may eat three chapatis are there, but North Indian people more and more chapati eat. That means in Punjab and Haryana, wheat is a main food crop. Punjab and Haryana and some other North Indian states, wheat is a main food crop. The wheat is cash crop in our South Indian states. That means very oftenly we use this wheat, but North Indian states use very little paddy. So that means what I understand, in one state's food crop treat as a cash crop in another states. Understand? So far what I explained you, yes, what is the importance of the agriculture? Why do you cultivate the agriculture? How many types of agriculture? That is called as extensive agriculture, intensive agriculture and podo agriculture. Where the podo agriculture may cultivate, I told very clearly. Yes, okay. So these are the information about the different guys. And also I explained about simple subsistence farming and intensive subsistence farming explained. These are the information about agriculture. Predominantly, our Indian agriculture is the backbone of our Indian economy still today. Even though industries are well developed, our service sector is also well developed, still today, the many people of India depend upon agriculture only. It provide the number of employment opportunities when you compare it to industrial sector and service sector. That means I told industries are developed because of that production is well developed. Production is only developed. Yes, sufficient employment opportunities not available in industrial sector also. But still today, agriculture sector is providing employment opportunities. Of course, nowadays It is 1972-73, that is 74% of people are depend upon agriculture, but nowadays reduced only 53 because the many people are getting education. Yes, you are expected a better life for that. So after finish our education, we will expect better employment opportunities. This is, we have to learn another important information in the next classes. Thank you very much.